If only a few hundred materials are available, only small buildings can be designed. However, if 10,000, even 100,000 materials are available, churches, houses, factory halls, castles, even palaces can be built. These are not my words. These are the words by the Nobel Prize winner, Professor Hermann Staudinger, the founder of plastics chemistry, 100 years ago. He laid down the groundwork that enabled many, many industries. His innovation laid down the path for our modern life today. Cars, trains, planes, smartphones, laptops, pipes, windmills, all employing polymer innovations. And to close the loop on Staudinger's building analogy, also building structures are nowadays very much relying on the polymer properties. Look at our daily lives. Go to any supermarket, and their efficiency in terms of structural insulation, both outside and inside, is an outcome of the ideas of Staudinger laid 100 years ago. But while the chemical sector is a supplier of many key industries, what's absolutely undeniable is at the same time, plastic waste is one of the biggest challenges in the world. It is absolutely clear that plastic pollution in the environment must be stopped. It's non-negotiable. And this is not the only challenge our planet has. At the same time, we are fighting the pandemic. We are fighting climate change. Huge challenges. But we, you and I, the stakeholders around us, are stepping up. And that gives me confidence. Our clients, our partners, governments, yes, even the capital markets have a clear awareness that these topics can be solved, but only together. We as the suppliers have a responsibility to drive progress in the downstream industries. We can't step away from that responsibility. And we as the society, of course, expect this as well. Polymer science has many of the answers. And circular economy, that is the framework to solve these fundamental challenges. So what do I mean by that? We need to depart from one of use. We need to avoid waste as much as possible. We need to stop wasting carbon without recovery. And yes, we need to establish consistent value creation cycles. Research and development is the heart, of course, of any innovative company. And of course, the cradle for more sustainable products. Sustainable products that are based on alternative raw materials. Renewable energy, which is so important, all designed, yes, designed for recycling. And that can help reshape the future. The first 100 years of polymer science were great. The next 100 years can be transformational, absolutely transformational. There are already promising advances in recycling technologies, also chemical recycling, alternative raw materials, and renewable energy. So I'm convinced, together, you and I, we can make the world fully circular. Follow us, join us. We will be fully circular.